But when you finished football, you just said, that's it. Now, what? Why was that? Why was it such a definitive cut-off and on you go?
Basically, after my divorce to Mandy Smith, I was at Millwall and I just had a real bad time of it. The press surrounded me all over the place, whether it was football and then it was her. So I just had enough and I said, sod it. Mm. You know what I mean? I just wanted out. And I went missing for a few months, tried to hide it a little bit. And then I got a phone call from my attorney, Nick Traynor. And he said to me, do you fancy South Africa? So I thought, geez, South Africa. But all they portray on the news is all the violence and what's going on over there, you know. So yeah, I spoke to a couple of guys, Frank Mervinson, Keith Birchin, that have actually been over there and had a holiday and played. And they said, it's a beautiful place, beautiful place. He said, "There's you don't see hardly any of the crap that goes on, you know what I mean?"
Yeah. But is there some sort of way? Did you meet the craze through boxing?
No, through friends.
Through friends and stuff. So, I mean, football in those days, I mean, there you were, and as you say, you had a high-profile relationship. You were playing for, you know, an absolutely sensational team, and I suppose that brought with it, didn't it, these types of meetings with, you know, let's just say famous and infamous people in the scene, yeah?
Well, it's just part and parcel of it, I should imagine, isn't it, you know? Sometimes you meet these type of people and sometimes you don't.
We look at these relationships today and even though they're high profile, the Posh and Bex and stuff, they're protected. I'm assuming back then you didn't have, I mean, we just remind people, it was way pre-internet, pre-that type of thing, pre where we even talked about kind of celebrity couples that much. Did it feel like sort of very unprotected when you were with somebody who had such a high profile? She was obviously very famous to those people.
Who's that, Mandy?
Yeah. Was that just, in hindsight, a wonderful thing, mate? But that wasn't you, was it, all of
no,
that?
No, it was definitely not me. And it just changed my life a little bit, you know, because I was used to just having that little bit for myself as a footballer.
Mm.
But then I walked into another world and it was like, it's not my cup of tea. Mm-hmm. If I can say, you know. Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, South Africa was the way out of that. That was, it was great for you. And I know there was a definitely real depression after football. Did, you know, have you managed to, I know we got to let you go soon in a minute, but did you manage to rebuild your life from there? And is that, you know, in hindsight, but was that exactly the right thing to do, get away from football?
Well, it was then, as you say, leaving England to go to Africa or Africa to come here again.
Yeah, no, when you originally went out there, was that definitely in the end the very best decision for you?
I think so, yeah. I just wanted to switch off and just possibly start all over again, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But like I say, things change. I just got divorced again about 10 months ago. So after 18 years with another person, then it's like you find yourself back to square one again, you know what I mean? Sometimes it's just, I was going to swear there, but...
I'm glad you didn't.
No.